Hi everyone! In this video, I'll show you how to put together this packaging design using Illustrator files directly in Substance Painter. This new feature of Painter allows you to open whole Illustrator files and apply the included artboards as fill layers. You can then apply to them all your familiar effects. I have a juice carton here that I will use as an example, and I have structured my layer stack so that I have one background for each flavor, orange, banana, and apple, in a folder called Background. I've made a graphics folder where I'm going to place the imported from Illustrator graphics. I also have a color correction layer, and I have a surface folder where I have added some imperfections and other reality cues to make my rigid CAD model more believable. In Illustrator, I have a document with several artboards where I have placed the graphics that I wish to use on my package. Every graphic is placed individually on a separate artboard. You could of course use graphics that contain the full package design for each flavor, but in this case we will work by placing individual graphics on the model. You also want to give your artboards distinct names so that you can recognize them in Painter. Save your Illustrator document normally. Then, you need only drag and drop this file into Painter. Dropping it into the 3D view will place it in warp projection mode as a material. Dropping it in the 2D view will place it in UV mode as a material. And dropping it in your layer stack will place it in UV mode in a specified channel. In this case, I choose base color. You can now place it where you want in your stack, scale it, and position it. In most cases, you will want to not have it repeat. In the layer options, you will see that you have some file type specific settings. You will find all of your artboards here, and you can switch between them. This is a great way to work, as you can essentially create a whole design by using just one Illustrator document and then swapping the artboards. Illustrator files contain vector graphics, which are resolution independent and can scale up without losing quality. The default option here is auto, and this will set the graphics at the resolution of your Painter project. But you can also use other resolutions, cropping settings, and non-square aspect ratios. Scope will let you select which objects to use from your Illustrator artboards. In this example, I have a layer with a group, which itself contains several other groups and elements. This can all be viewed and selected within the scope window, and you can even have thumbnails. Another great thing about this workflow is that you can continue to work non-destructively on your Illustrator graphics in Painter by applying to them filters and other effects. Let's apply a drop shadow filter to this logo to separate it from the background. Let's place another graphic. You can find your imported document in the Project Textures section of your library. This time, drag it into the 2D view to activate the material mode and the UV projection and select another graphic. This way, you will have access to more settings for scale, position, outline, additional channels like roughness and height, and color correction like luminosity, contrast, hue, and saturation. If you're working with specific color spaces, you can also apply them here. Okay, one more graphic, this time into the 3D view. This will place it in warp projection mode, so that you can drag and place it along the surface of the model, ignoring the model's seams. Hit W on the keyboard to move, E to rotate, and R to scale it. Press Q to toggle the gizmo on or off. To separate this barcode from the background, let's go in Settings and give it a thin outline. Let's duplicate this layer and change its scope so that we are using only the text. Let's make it embossed and metallic. All right, let's place a recycle icon in the 3D view and add a levels effect or an HSL filter to color it green. If you change your mind and want to place this on the UV map, you can easily go to the projection settings of the layer and change it. You can go back and forth anytime. Once you've placed all your graphics, it's incredibly easy to make variations by switching artboards. You can even keep working on your Illustrator graphics and update them in Painter by reloading your Illustrator document. Here are some variations on the design I made. I hope this was helpful. See you in my next video!